Located at the intersection of Bramalea Road and Duxbury Road in Brampton, the new proposal for the Carebra Hospice focuses on improving the quality of life and dignity until the very end. Please join me in the exploration of the design process. It was very important to me to respond directly to the site and its surroundings. At a macro level, the neighborhood we are in is primarily residential, especially taking into consideration the new residential development across the street. For that reason, I considered the materiality, the landscaping, the scale of the building, and the shape of the roof to work in harmony with what's already existing. As we can see in the context plan, a key element of our site is its adjacency to the Green Belt and the Campbell Cross Creek. As explored in our site analysis, these natural features create an optimal microclimate that would be beneficial to all users of the space. For that reason, I pushed the building as close as possible to that area. In the site plan here, we can see how I built up to the north edge of the allowed area and extended the outdoor patios to the edge of the property line. To create a transitional space between our site and the protected zone, I'm suggesting planting similar trees in between. However, there needs to be an application to the city planning office. In regards to zoning and bylaws related to the site, the building fits inside the constructible lot area and covers 1,360 square meters, which is lower than the 33% permitted. The main access to the building is placed 20 meters away from the street. Now, in terms of design, I focused on the concept of passage. This relates to the overall purpose of a hospice and easing the transition from life to death. I'm showing this concept through the form and the experience. The building is divided into public spaces and the residence. The two are connected by a glazed corridor, offering views of a beautiful landscaping and representing a clear threshold. This is also an opportunity to pause and reflect. The diagram here shows the evolution of the form and how I broke down the building and adjusted the shape to fit the surrounding context. When designing, it was important for me to separate the residence from the rest of the building to allow for more privacy and reduce negative distractions such as unwanted sounds and smells. It also allows for nurses to monitor everyone that comes in and out of the space. To maximize space for landscaping on the ground floor, I placed most of the back of house program in the basement. When looking at the department plans, we start to understand the relationships between the spaces a lot more. We will first look at the residence. The residence suites were paired to break down the institutional feel. The small module would have a unique color to facilitate wayfinding and promote individuality. The corridor adjacent to the room was made larger to accommodate for seating and informal gathering outside of the bedroom. The bedrooms are all oriented towards north to allow for views of nature and prevent overexposure to direct sunlight. There's an overhead patient lift connecting directly to the bathroom. This allows to safely move residents around. Additionally, all doors are at least 1.2 meters to allow for wheelchair access, and the main door and patio door are large enough for a bed and large equipment to pass through. Side note, most doors leading to residents, staff, or public spaces have an accessible clearance, and it's shown in dashed. The bedroom has a lot of storage space for personal belongings, allowing for a more personalized experience. The bedroom also includes a clear stowy window, allowing the south sunlight to glide through during winter months. The bedroom opens up to a covered outdoor patio that extends to the limits of our property line to offer even more opportunities for views and gathering in the beautiful natural environment. In between residence suites units are family rooms, including a kitchenette for family members staying for a long time. In residence are also the soil utility and clean supply rooms for easier access for staff. Their nursing station is centrally located and includes a lounge room and outdoor patio for nurses. also accommodated for a bariatric bedroom and air pressurized room. The public spaces are located at the front of the building. The great room is adjacent to the reception area and includes a fireplace and TV to create positive distractions and give a home-like feel to the space. As requested, I also included a multi-sensory room in that area. There also are two washrooms, one universal and one accessible. All washrooms in the building are wheelchair accessible. The admin area is composed of private offices, shared office, and counseling rooms. To maximize space, I created one multi-purpose room to accommodate all activities requiring a large meeting space. In this area is the staff entrance. Upon arrival, there is the coat storage and staff area. The basement is mostly for mechanical, electrical, and back of house. I also included staff washrooms as well as a change room, staff storage, and a shower. The back of house portion includes laundry, linen storage, and assembly, the central storage, and I also included a separate area for food storage and a walk-in freezer. Overall, the net area of the building is now at 1,160 square meters, which is lower than the 1,290 square meters that was programmed before. The construction of the building will be in mass timber. The exposed roof and columns will give an overall warmer feel to the building. I used a radial grid for the public building. For the residence, the same grid has been broken down into segments of parallel lines at equal distance to facilitate construction. All residence units, except for the one including the bariatric room, are all standardized in terms of structural system. I'm also showing the location of the mechanical shafts, fire panel, and emergency exit. This is what concludes the presentation. We will close with images showing how it all comes together. Thank you.